Today is clean the barn day. About twice a year, I have to do this, and I dread it, because it's just messy. I have to go after the cobwebs, I have to sort the shelves, and we have dirt floors in our barn, so everything gets dusty. It's gotta be done. I have to get organized. Okay. Better get to work. Ick. Wow, finally done. It probably doesn't look any better to you, but trust me, this is a much more organized, cleaner barn than when I started. The main thing is to get the cobwebs down. I still have to do the stalls. They're still a little dirty. Not as bad as the interior of the barn, but, well, you can't see. But anyway, I still have to do the stalls, but that'll be a little job compared to what this was. And then I cleaned out the shelves above where our new rabbit hutches are going to go, our rabbit cages. And I'm hoping I can store all my rabbit pellets up there, as well as some other supplies. I'm tired. And just did some basic organizing and clean house and all this other stuff. I hate doing this job. I still got some little things to organize. But basically, I'm done, and I've got some extra space now, which I desperately needed. Okay, those last two segments on cleaning the barn, getting organized, etc., that's my segue into what I really want to talk about. And that is the best way for long-term storage of animal feed. What are you guys doing? And if you wouldn't mind volunteering, how long are you storing for? I've been in a quandary about that. Now, we buy all our feedstuffs. We don't produce anything on the farm. We buy everything for the animals off-site. Now, we have pasture in the summer. That's about the only thing we produce, for the animals anyway. But I do buy my hay in about a year's worth at a time. And if I have to, I think I can get 2 years, I think. So that's not my problem. But the grains. The grains are, I think, problematic for two reasons. Number one, so much of it has sweet feed at, or molasses added, like sweet feed or grains that you'd feed a goat in production. That's the first thing I think would work against you with long-term storage. And the second thing is most of your animal grains, your laying mash, scratch grain, cracked corn, rolled oats, etc., they've been milled in some way, shape, or fashion. And so you've broken that protective outer hull on the grain, and that works against you with long-term storage. That's why when you have wheat berries and you're going to bake bread, you don't mill your flour up until shortly before you're going to make the bread. So what do you do with animal feed that's been milled? Now, I don't have the equipment to do my own milling of animal grain. I can't just buy the raw ingredients and mix it as I go, which would probably be the ideal. But what's the next best thing? And how long do you think we can store things like laying mash and scratch grain or something with molasses in it? Now, the pelleted feed, the processed feed, rabbit pellets, dog, cat food, I think we're going to be fine. I think you can store those for quite a long time. But it's the other stuff that's got me worried. And then on top of that, I've got all these lists of peripheral things that you need, like your wormers, and your minerals, black form or loose form. For me, fly spray, other veterinary supplies, bedding. And that's something I'm trying to do right now, is make a more extensive veterinary kit for my barn. I do keep quite a bit of medicine on hand and veterinary supplies, but who knows? You know, so I'm trying to prepare there. And speaking of veterinary medicines, did you know you can get all kinds of antibiotics relatively cheaply and without a prescription online? They're fish antibiotics, and they come in pill form, and there's all kinds of them out there, and they're not that expensive. There's a whole bunch on eBay, for example. Now, I'm not advocating that you put those in your medicine cabinet for people. I'm just saying they're there, and I'm going to pick up some for my animals. Anyway, getting back to my original topic, I'd like to hear what you're doing, how you're storing grain, what time frame, if you feel comfortable volunteering that, you're storing for, and maybe you've got some creative ways to store. Please don't say Mylar bags and buckets, because I don't think I'm going to have enough buckets for that. But if you've got any other ideas, I'm all ears. Because I'm just spinning my wheels here, and so I'm looking for feedback. And this is Lucy, by the way. She's my house cat. It's the best house cat I've ever had. All right, that's all, YouTube. I'm looking forward to your comments.